Good morning and welcome to America's Home Cooking. Today I'm making applesauce biscuits. And first thing I'm going to have to do is dehydrate some of them, thicken up actually. They say to slowly cook your applesauce until it's thin. Let me see how they want you to do it. All right. You're going to simmer your applesauce over medium heat until thickened and all the excess liquid has been evaporated. Now what I've done is I added raisins to mine because I want to put raisins in these, but just plain applesauce is fine. I'm just partial with the raisins. And raisins are also high in iron, so it's an extra place where you can get it. So I've started that. Oh, and how much applesauce are you going to need? Sorry about that. They say 2 cups of a sweetened applesauce, and you're going to just cook the excess liquid out, which is going to take about 15, 20 minutes, and I'll be back. Okay, when your applesauce gets thick, you're just going to sit there and let it cool some because we're going to have to handle it and it's got to cool some and I'll be back. Okay, we're going to need 2 cups of an all-purpose flour. We're going to need 1/4 cup of granulated sugar, which is white sugar. You don't know it by that term. And we're going to need 2 teaspoons of baking powder. And 1 teaspoon of cardamom, which is a very lovely seasoning that you don't see very often in recipes. You're going to mix all of this together. Let's see. You know what I'm going to have to do. Next, they want you to add, you're going to need a pastry blender or 2 knives, and we're going to cut a stick of butter into that. Got a little soft. Now you're going to work this just like you do biscuits. You want it to be crumbly. While we're doing this, add 1 tablespoon of wheat germ, which is 3 teaspoons. Now I would normally add powdered milk to this, but this is made with heavy cream, so I'm going to bypass that. But we definitely need that wheat germ in there. I should have added it before I added the butter, but it's okay. And when you get a nice texture like this, getting ready to add the next ingredient. Which is going to be heavy cream. They say you can use milk. I have used milk, but it doesn't have the richness of flavor that you're looking for. This is why I use the heavy cream. So if you don't want that richness, use milk by all means. But it's a fourth of a cup. And we're also going to need an egg cracked into it. I'm going to beat this together with a fork, which I've shown you how to do. I forgot my fork. Do they want anything else in this? Let me see. Now, they don't want you to use this. They want you to stir this in. So I think a fork would be the best. I've had this recipe, and I still have to read it each and every time. I've made it like 5 times already. But when you have that many recipes, you find out you're going to be doing a lot of reading. You have to repeat reading old recipes. Oh, it's funny, the only recipes I remember are the ones when I was a little girl. Oh, like I remember hash. It came from Anya Mary. There was no recipe. All these other ones I have to sit there and think and read. As you mix this, you're going to see it's coming into a dough, a lovely dough. I'm going to get it all mixed up thoroughly into a dough that we can work with. Are going to need a rolling pin, and if you're not good, you're going to need a little ruler to get the measurements right. So this will be sitting a bit while we get the rest of the stuff ready. There's more that we have to do. It's coming together nicely. You are definitely going to need a very dry counter for what we're going to do next. Yeah, that's wet. Okay. We are going to need I'm looking. We have to line a baking sheet with foil. Now we're going to have to flour this surface, and we have to roll this out 20 by 8 inch rectangle. Gonna need a ruler. Remember, if you have to make a long rectangle shape, it's best you start shaping it before you start rolling it out, so you have a better grip of getting it where you want it to go. And that's what I'm going to do right now, stretch it out by squeezing it to get it to a length. They want 20 inches, and I've already got 11, and I haven't even started rolling it out. To warn you ahead of time, this is messy. With me making these, they are messy, but they're so good, you can't complain. All right, I'm at 13 inches, got 7 more to go. See, I'm not so worried about getting the 8 inches right now, I just am trying to get the 20 inches. Then after that, we can work on that part. But I'm going to press it out as much as I can before I start rolling it. It starts sticking to the rolling pin and everything else. And remember, if I overshoot, I always squeeze the edges back in so I get a perfect one. And see, I've already gotten the width. I've already got the width at 5 inches, so by doing it like this, you control the shape and everything else, which makes it easier. dough's gonna try to stick to your hands, and what you're gonna have to do is be forceful about it and not let it do what it wants to do, but it does what you want it to do. This is where I take control. They don't like it. You have to take some control. If you don't, it'll just keep splitting and just messing you up all the way around. Okay. Being careful, try not to tear the batter, or the dough, I should say. That's just about 8 inches. We are a half inch off of 20. Now you have to say that's good. Keep checking, because it can shrink up in an edge when you try to block it. Because we go in one direction. See, I lost it. That's what you have to worry about. Now they wanted me to turn the oven on before I get to this point, but the problem is I'm a little slow on doing this one, so I'm not going to turn the oven on until I get a little further into this, and then I'll be turning the oven on. Okay, now we're going to turn the oven on to 425.
Now we're gonna cut 10 squares out. We're gonna cut this in half and then we're gonna make fifths out of it. This is 8 inches. This is 4 here. There's 4 here. There's 4 here. And there's 4 here. So now what you're going to do is line them up. Make sure you put flour on it, or it's not going to work on your knife. All right, so these have to be 4 inches. Right? Yeah. 4 times 5 is 20. Okay, so we'll just go this way. 4. I think 4 is more over here. 8. 12. Alright, just draw a line and you're going to cut them. Make sure, like I said, you get flour on your knife. You're going to need it. Thank God I was good in math. I would be really having problems. All right, you should have 10 squares, okay? Now what we're going to do is get that applesauce on it. Okay. They say cut them into 4-inch squares. Well, that's somewhere around. And spread a tablespoon across the center of each square to within 1/2 inch of the edge. And see, you can see the applesauce. This is how you want it. It's got to be dry like this. I know the raisins make it a little bit bulky, but I happen to like raisins in mine. If you have any of this left, it goes great in plain yogurt. So you don't have to waste any applesauce that you have. I remember correctly. I'm going to have trouble with these sticking. Okay. Why didn't you tell me the glasses were behind me so I could at least know where I'm going? They want you to roll each square, pinch the seams to seal. I know they're going to give me problems doing that.
Well, I've made these before.
I will add a little bit of water on the edges. Rinse this off. I did lick it. God, I hope you guys don't give me a problem. But I just feel it in my bones you're going to do it. That's right. You are. I'm going to go back through this again. I am going to wet the edges because I know what I'm going to be going through. They don't tell you to do this, but when you roll these up, they do have a tendency to seep. The problem is I don't want it to seep too much. Let's see, if I'm going to roll this over this way, I'm going to put it here. Yep, that's what I thought. These are a mess to make. That's why I warned you, these are messy. Just pinch the edges down. They want you to put them down like that. Just pinch those edges. I just want to make sure it's free so I can roll it. So the sides you pinch are where I'm putting the water to make sure that they seal when I pinch them. And then what the seam that I'm rolling to, I add some water so those seals better. And that's what they look like. Take a little work, but they're well worth it. I won't lie to you. They are good. See, they're going to seep. No matter what you do, they're going to seep. So be prepared for that. And they do crack open too. I don't need it wet. I'm trying to. take a little time and patience. But you are never going to be disappointed with these. They don't even last in the house 2 days.
How long are they going to cook?
Okay, well, we're not ready for that yet, anyway. That's the only thing they don't do is give you instructions to wet the edges. The only edge you don't wet is the one that you're rolling over the applesauce. The other three sides have to be.
That helps them seal a little
better. We'll get the rest done and we'll get them in the oven to really. These fries are really quite nice.
Alright, now what am I going to do? We need another egg lightly beaten.
Okay, I have my fork. Brush these. you are going to take your sugar and sprinkle them with sugar. To bake them for 12 minutes. So I'll be back in 12 minutes. Okay, the first batch is coming out. Do not try taking these off right away. They have to cool some. And then be careful when you do take them off, that they don't, you'll have to probably sometimes peel the foil off the back, but just be real careful. Wait a minute, 34 is the next batch. Anyway, I'll show them to you. It's going to be a little difficult. Here they are. Do let them cool a bit. And then move them to let them cool on a rack. That's what I'm leaving it on there for, okay? So anyway, that's how you make applesauce biscuits. Take care.